Romans 5 and verse 12. What a comprehensive verse that is. For it categorized sin that has come into the world. A careful perusal from Genesis 1:1 to Revelation 22:21. Sin is categorized in every dispensation. Sin separates God and man according to Isaiah 59:1-2. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that he cannot save, neither is his ear heavy that he cannot hear. I wonder, does God need a hearing aid? Has his arm withered up so far? And I'm using the doctrine of anthropomorphism, that he cannot reach out and save Israel. It is your sins and your iniquities that has separated between you and your God. And as long as you stay in sin, I'll turn a deaf ear to your prayer. Isaiah 59:1-2. We lie down in our shame and our confusion covered us. For we have sinned against God.
Yes, sir.
We and our fathers, even until the youth of this day, have not obeyed the voice of the Lord our God. That's a harder description of sin in Jeremiah's day.
Yes, sir.
Jeremiah 3:25.
Yes, sir.
The whole land is full of sin. Jeremiah 51:5.
Yes,
write the sin of Judah with an indelible pen. Jeremiah 17:1. The best of them is like a bride. They do evil with both hands earnestly. Micah 7:3-4. They rose up early to corrupt all their doings. Zephaniah 3:7. Rebellious children add sin to sin. Isaiah 30:1. They sin more and more. Hosea 13:2. The wicked at all will not be acquitted. Nahum 1:3. God's eyes is too pure to behold evil, and cannot stand and look upon iniquity. Habakkuk 1:13. There is not a just man that doeth good and sinneth not. Ecclesiastes 7:20. All have sinned. Romans 3:23. And the wages of sin is? Death have passed unto all men. For all have sinned. Romans 5:12. When we think about the first recorded sin, we think about how those heavenly bodies in sin, how those heavenly bodies in heaven sin against God. And it's so interesting. Well, God spared not the angels that sin against him in heaven, but cast them down into Tartarus. That one word that we have, hell. Cast them down into Tartarus. Reserved there for the judgment. 2 Peter 2:4. Neighbor, this is the first sin that we read about in our Bibles. And it's so interesting to me. When those heavenly bodies sinned against God, God did not devise a scheme of redemption. But when man sinned, neighbor, it bankrupted heaven. Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yea, hath God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. And the woman said unto the serpent, ye shall not surely die, for God doth know, in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing both good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof, she did eat, and gave also unto her husband, which he did eat. Genesis 3, 1 to 6. Nay, but this is the first sin that man committed against God. And when man sinned, God started heading toward Calvary. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Genesis 3, verse 15. Genesis 3, 15 is God's first hint of redeeming mankind back from his sins. Yes, now I would like to begin our study tonight and drill that preparatory material. This is what I want to do. I want to draw a bloodline from Genesis 3:15, and I'll stop periodically, but I'm headed to Calvary's cross. All right. And when I leave Calvary's cross, I'm gonna draw that bloodline to the Church of Christ. Yes, now, brothers and sisters, friends and neighbors, I'm gonna show some things that we only have one Christ, we can only have one church. Oh, yeah. Now, if you're gonna agree with the prophets that say there is only one Jesus, then you will have to agree with the same prophet that says there is only one church. Now here we have the first sin of mankind in the Garden of Eden. God put those trees. That tree in the garden did not catch God off guard. According to 2 Timothy 1:9 and Ephesians 1:4-6, God already had a scheme of redemption into his mind before man ever sinned. And so God, what he does, through his omnibenevolence, he put all of those trees out there in the garden. And he tells Adam, out of all of these trees you can freely eat. I have a minute that was. But the tree that is in the midst of the garden, now here Eve comes along. She could not appreciate the goodness of God. She could not, that one tree had her attention so much, she couldn't even appreciate all of the trees that she could have. Her attention was on the one tree that she could have, and it doomed mankind. And so what God started doing, he started issuing out punishments and judgments in Genesis 3 and verse 15. That first hint that he was going to save mankind through the seed of a woman. He's going to save mankind through the seed of a woman. Now look what we have. We have two people in the world, and the devil got both of them. That's Adam and Eve. So what Adam and Eve does? Adam knew his wife, and then they have two sons. Those two sons were Cain and Abel. And right off the bat, Cain killed Abel. Abel was the seed of promise. Hold it, wait a minute, God. How are you gonna get the seed of woman into the world to save mankind from his sins now when there's only three people in the world and the devil got all three of them? Genesis chapter 4, Adam knew his wife and then had another son.